boys, are you ready for the show? Hi, Typhoon. You get to come with, buddy. Hi, Caspian. Come here. Oh, you're such a good boy. So it's time to get these boys loaded up, and we're gonna get their hay and their feed ready, and then load them into the trailer. I think Andi and Caspian are gonna do awesome at the show.
Well, we finally made it to the show, and Andi is ready to show her goat Caspian. As you can see behind us, we have Caspian in the crate and also Typhoon because we brought him along for a buddy.
We just came from the weigh-in. Caspian came in at 63 pounds,
which is awesome.
It's 8 more pounds than when I weighed him last. I can't exactly pinpoint when I weighed him last, but he was 55. So he's definitely gaining steadily.
Yeah, and I think he looks pretty show ready, and he's ready to be shown. How do you feel about this whole show thing, Andi? Are you ready for it?
Not necessarily ready, but you gotta have your first show at some point.
Exactly. I think you'll do awesome. Well, let's have a high five for first show. Woohoo! All right, we'll see you in a little bit when Andi's in the show ring.
Say, well, who are you? Oh, and there he stood in the door of that shack, and his beard and his hair was long and black, and he was the biggest man I'd ever seen. When he spoke, his voice was low and deep, and he just couldn't fight me, cause somehow I just knew he wasn't me. He said, what you doing snooping around my place? And I saw a smile come across his face, so I smiled back and I told him who I was.
I told you anything, so. what we have here is I pulled four out to choose from our champion and reserve. And I talked to our back row back there. Again, there's very minor things that some of these are doing that we can change to get them to jump over to this side. That's just one night how they're acting and responding in that particular night. This is tough out here. I want to talk about these just a little bit. Let's talk about the young lady in the end here at fourth. And again, they're in no particular order whatsoever out here. This doe's really elegant, really attractive up to her front end, and she accentuates that when she gets this one stuck. She allows that head and neck to really show itself off. Maybe not as good in her top line, and she struggles to get that top line right, but this doe wants to push her loins, so it is something that's just difficult. I like her demeanor, I like her mannerisms in the ring, her professionalism, all those things are right. The young lady gets in front of her, the little doe. It's hard to show a goat this small. Guess what? She's getting the job done pretty well, really well. I would like to see her just ease up a little bit, maybe, I don't know how to explain it. We're putting quite a bit of pressure on that goat's upper neck and chin and throat latch area, where if we could transition to where the right there, where the pressure's down more closer to your knee, that way we can shut that front end off just a little bit better, but really have these goats stuck. The young man right here, here's a doe that really presents herself nicely once he gets her stuck. She's not an easy one. She's not as cooperative as some of the others out here, but he seems to manage that and adapt and do it very, very well. I probably appreciate his ability to understand where that animal's at. And as soon as that leg moves just a little bit without him looking at it, he knows where it's at and goes back and sets it. Where on occasion, it takes just a little bit longer for some of the others to do so. The young lady that we have up here in the front line, again, really, really solid all the way through. I'd like to push the head and neck back ever so slightly and drop that chin just a little bit right there. Perfect. And give me just a little more shoulders so we're not covering quite as much up, and you're dead on track. Some of these goats want to cooperate. Some of these goats don't want to cooperate. Tremendous set of young people out here, not only in this first row, but the second. As I go out to shake the hand of our champion reserve, let's give them all a nice round of applause, if you would, please.
Okay, good. show up, look around, but you don't see her face. They tell you she probably went back to her place, so you go. And you knock on her door, but she won't let you in. She ain't ready to do this again, so you go.
As we get into this particular class, I think we do have some unique differences that present themselves. The goat that wins this class does it very easy in several ways. If you study this one's fore rib, you study this one's dimension in terms of the dimension he has down his top and through his loin and back into his hip, he wins in all those areas quite easily. Is he a notch shorter body? And does he come out of that wither into his top line just a touch easier than where I'd like? Yes, he does, but I'll tell you what, his bone work, his chest floor, his neck, his incredible handle and dimension you're out behind him, I don't think you could deny this one winning this class. The young lady in second, again, real intense young showman, I'm just overly impressed with her abilities to get this done. What do I like more about this goat in second than the one that leads? This is even a longer neck goat, yet considerably longer body, probably just a notch better in that top line. What do I want to change about this goat? If I study this one up in the chest floor and I study this one's fore rib, I want to open that up, and I think that's going to come with maturity. The more age and time this one has, probably the better. I'd like to stop this one up when I get around behind relative to the goat that wins the class, but this one has so much good about it in terms of that length and extension. This one has that, those qualities you can play on a much bigger stage if we open up a little bit, if we develop a little more muscle with maturity. I think those things will come. A little bit different goat falls into third. This one has a kind of muscle or similar muscle to what we find up in our first place goat in terms of a big rack, a big top, a stout hip, a wide pin set. Is he a little shorter necked? Is he a little wrinklier hided? Is he a little shorter and steeper hip? Yes to all of those things, but he's busted open, he's pretty muscular, and I think he's acceptable in terms of his skeletal build. Coming into fourth, the young lady's got a nice goat. I like this goat. I like the forearm. I like how he's opened up. He has enough width and dimension. Maybe not that just perfect handle, that massive handle that we find up there. Maybe not the show ring presence of a couple of them, but I tell you what, this one has all the basics that we really want. From a fundamental standpoint, very difficult to pick on this one anywhere, just not those show ring dynamics that maybe would come into play. Likewise, young lady next in line, the goat doesn't want to put his tail up. That makes it hard to evaluate him in terms of giving him that great look. But guess what? He's not a steep hip goat. He's actually, one of his strengths are, he comes out of that shoulder into his top line really well. He's ultra level out through that hip. He gets a little bit flatter in his forehead. I'd like to push that chest floor up, and as we do that, it's going to round that rib cage out, and all of a sudden gives us a completely different handle and different look. Again, like one we talked about in front of, fundamentally good, not maybe as tricked out, not those extra bells and whistles that we find in some of the others. Excellent set from top to bottom. Let's give them a nice hand, if you would, please.
All right, congratulations, class two. We have Julia Lester and Macy Zerbach returning for the Prospect Market Goat Drive.
Thanks so much for watching this video. Andi did pretty well at the goat show. She gave it her best, and that's all that matters. It was pretty hard to get first place at this show because there was a lot of competition there, and of course this was Andi's very first show. So I thought that she did really well for her first show because she did a lot of great prep work beforehand. Practicing with Caspian, getting him used to her, and we were able to get him all clipped up and ready for the show beforehand. So all of those things is what matters, and the fact that she went in that ring and she went to her very first goat show, it definitely takes a lot of guts. So way to go, Andi. Please don't forget to like this video. Also go down, ring that notification bell so you don't miss a video that I post, and hit that subscribe button so you can follow along with all of my goat adventures. If you want to see a playlist of the goat shows that I've been to, click right here. Thanks again, and see you later!